You'll always be my number one. A whole lot more than good enough. Giving everything I've got to gain every second lost. 6 years just ain't enough. With you, I'm happy being me. Don't pretend, cause I don't need to. I'm 1,000 miles from home, never on my own. When you whispered down the phone, well, I guess we never saw this coming. Halfway around the world calling, but I just want you to know that I'd have all I need. You were standing right in front of me. Chasing gold. Anywhere with you, I'll call my home. Oh, I'd have all I need if you'd be the better half of me. I'm still up, it's 4 a.m. Is this Amsterdam or Berlin? Yeah, I'm just waiting for the day I finally get to say these words face to face. Well, I guess we never saw this coming. Halfway around the world calling, but I just want you to know that I'd have all I need. You were standing right in front of me. For me, I'd have all I need if you were standing right in front of me. I'll finally see what it means to be complete. Don't need to spend my life chasing gold. Anywhere with you, I'll call my home. If you'd be the better half of me, yeah, will you be the better half of me? Will you be the better half of me?
True, because Beautiful day. Thank you, Lord, for this memorable day. Thank you, Lord, that as we gathered here in your name to witness this marriage, we thank you, Lord, for your presence here and for your involvement, Lord, in this marriage. Thank you, Lord, that marriage is from you and it's given to us as a gift. And so we pray, Lord, for this couple before us, that they would enjoy the gift that they are to each other, and they would enjoy the blessing of God in their lives as they walk this journey together. Thank you for this afternoon. Bless our ceremony. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Take your seats, please. Well, we've gathered together today at the invitation of Brent and Casey to share, eventually, to share in the joy of their wedding. This outward celebration we shall see and hear is an expression of their inner love and devotion they have in their hearts for each other. Jesus Christ reminds us that at the beginning, our Creator, God, made them male and female. And he said, "For this cause, a man shall leave his father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh." So God loved us and created us to love others. And our lives find completion only as we love and are loved in return. Together we can become what we could never be separately. Marriage is a gift from God. Brent and Casey are here today, desiring to be united in this sacred relationship. Brent, do you now take Casey as your wife, forsaking all others? Will you make a home for her where she'll be loved and cared for, cherished as God, as long as God grants her life?
I do.
Thank you, sir. That wasn't a hesitation. Casey, do you now take Brent as your husband, forsaking all others? Will you make a home together where he'll be loved, cherished, and cared for as long as God grants him life?
I do.
Thank you. And who is giving this woman to be married to this man?
We do.
We do.
I noticed Mike was a little more eager. There we are. But, you know, we're not going to read too much into this. I need to ask if there's anyone here who knows of any legal reason why Brent and Casey cannot be married today. We're moving on quickly. Okay, so we can move on. And I know the Labola's been taken care of. It's disputable. Okay, so you guys are looking amazing. We've cleaned up for the day. We've done our best. You've done your best. I saw you a couple of weeks ago, and it wasn't pretty. You're looking good. So this is it. This is where it's down to the wire. So We've already quoted that verse from chapter 2 of Genesis, verse 24. And we see that marriage is about becoming one flesh. And it's an interesting concept because we don't really know at what point that happens. But we know that it does happen. And that we still retain our own distinct personalities, but we become one flesh. And in some kind of way, we are in union. And that's what marriage does. So it starts here, in front of your friends and family, who incidentally are also a gift from God to you. And we're the ones who witness this, and the ones who say, hey, stop being an idiot. Right, guys? Yes, he is. And you ladies are going to say, citizen, you're going to listen, Casey? Just give him a bit of slap. All right. That's why we're here. That's why we have witnesses. And the official witnesses are going to sign the book later. So the two of you are here today desiring to enter this one flesh relationship as husband and wife. So we please join hands and face each other. Okay. Brent, will you repeat these words after me to Casey? I, Brent Colin Bauer.
I, Brent Colin Bauer.
In the presence of the Lord.
In the presence of the Lord.
And of our family and friends.
And of our family and friends.
Take you, Casey Ann Murphy.
Take you, Casey Ann Murphy.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are separated by death.
Until we are separated by death.
As God is my witness.
As God is my witness.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
Right. Is he? Oh, no. This is now red, ready, guys. Casey, will you repeat these words after me to say? I, Casey Ann Murphy.
I, Casey Ann Murphy.
In the presence of the Lord.
In the presence of the Lord.
And of our family and friends.
And of our family and friends.
Take you, Brent Colin Bauer.
Take you, Brent Colin Bauer.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are separated by death.
Until we are separated by death.
As God is my witness.
As God is my witness.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
Well done. Let's see whether we can hold this together. Brent, so those words. Yeah. That's a good best man there, Charles. I must say. Okay, Brent.
Here we go. Casey, I take you to be my best friend, my faithful partner, and my one true love. I promise to encourage you and inspire you, and to love you truly through good times and bad. I will forever be there to laugh with you, to lift you up when you're feeling down, and to love you unconditionally through all of our adventures and life together.
It's a two-page essay. See, you love each other anyway, more, hey? You know, more effort.
What's there, Mom? Brent, who would have thought you'd be standing here 10 years later? Through the last 10 years, we have faced many obstacles together. Some harder than others.
It'll be good.
You're okay, but
emotional relationship that we have today. I'll laugh and cry with you. When you need a friend, I'll be your best friend. I'll listen to hear instead of listening to respond. I will treat you with the patience, compassion, and understanding that you deserve. I'll always be right next to you, encouraging you as you chase and follow your dreams. I'll be your shoulder to lean on, your comfort, and your guiding light in times of dark. I will love you unconditionally, no matter what life throws at us. You are my best friend, my anchor, my confidant, and my biggest cheerleader. Thank you for accepting me for all that I am. Words will never be enough to express my love and promises to you. So instead, I'm going to stop now and show you for the rest of my life how much I love you. I chose you then, I choose you today, and I choose you forever. I will love you always. P.S. Please don't stop singing your made-up song.
I think let's give him a big clap. Best friend. Okay. Now, if you are married out there or have been, and I just want to throw a few little things out there that will help us understand some things. Men and women are more different than we think. Every single cell in our bodies is different. Women have a greater constitutional vitality, generally outliving men by 3 to 4 years. Women generally have a lower metabolism than men. Even in our skeletal makeup, construction, we are different. Women have a shorter head. Just throwing up there, this is this information for free. Broader face, less protruding chin, and shorter legs, but a longer torso. The first finger on a woman's hand is usually longer than the third. You can check that out if you want. Dance together, okay. And it's generally the reverse of men. You go and have a look. And listen, if you're a man and it applies to you, don't read anything into it, okay? All good. Just generally we're talking about. So, women generally have larger stomachs, not that way, but inside. Kidneys, yeah, going easy. Liver and appendix, but smaller lungs than men. A woman's blood contains more water, 20% fewer blood cells. And this less oxygen means that women tire easier and are more prone to fainting. In brute strength, men are 50% stronger, but women have more endurance. Woman's heart beats faster, and her blood pressure is around 10 points lower, and she has a less of a tendency to develop high blood pressure. A woman's vital capacity for breathing is lower. A woman can stand a higher temperature than men. We know this, which is a man's improvement. Man gets a bit of a temperature, he can't function. Girls must carry on. A woman has better close field vision than men. Men are better with far field vision, and so generally are better with direction. Not always, generally. A woman's brain allows her to do many things at once. A man, not so much. And it's proven. I mean, we can see this, but it's proven. A man can't find his underpants in his underpants drawer. And then I go, everywhere. And then she goes, I'm looking for these. Where did you find them? In your drawer. I looked. We can't find the milk in the fridge. Then there's a lot of things, and it's to do with how we made. Psychologists tell us that women need to speak 15 to 20,000 words a day. Men, often around 8,000 or less. So that was borne out by this exercise we just done. he writes a poem that took him 3 days to get, right? And it's, you know, lucky if he got 15 words in there, but... Just making a point. Men communicate in headlines, women communicate in fine print. So, the woman asks the man, how are you doing? He goes, fine. Doesn't tell her anything. She needs to know way more than that. Women communicate to be connected to and bond. Men communicate to fix problems. If you've got a problem, you have to process it verbally. He then thinks, oh, I've got to fix this. So he only communicates to fix it, and invariably it ends up with you're overreacting. And then the war's on. That's not what she needs to hear. So when women communicate to bond and men communicate to fix, then she feels like he doesn't care. He's got no feelings. So he does. He's giving her his best thing. That's to fix the problem. They say that 72% of human communication is non-verbal, meaning facial expressions, watching, you know, a whole lot of other things that are non-verbal, and women are particularly good at picking up non-verbal cues. Men haven't a clue. So, and generally women nod in a conversation, they nod not to agree, they nod to be included. Men nod or don't nod if they agree or disagree. I got caught once, I was trying to multitask, and I was listening to Abby, and I was reading an email at the same time. Big mistake. So I was going, and then she said, what have I just said? And I had no answer, because I wasn't listening. So, we are different. We are so different to each other, and yet God, in His infinite wisdom, puts us together for the rest of our lives. I don't get it. But he does. In Genesis 2 verse 18, he says, it is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him. A helper suitable for him. Yo, a helper, not superior, not inferior, equal, but different. No one better than the other, no one's got more brains than the other. Well, I don't know. We haven't worked that out yet. But no one superior or inferior. We add help, and help, a helper adds value where it's lacking. Assists, it brings. And so we need each other. We need each other. Brent, you need this girl. You need her in your life. Casey, you need this boy in your life. So you are God's gift to each other. Remember that when you, in the heat of a disagreement, remember that you are God's gift. God has in grace and mercy given you friends. He's given you Casey. Cherish each other, nurture each other, support each other, protect each other, care for each other, love each other. You're a gift from heaven for each other. Proverbs 18, verse 22 says that he who finds a wife finds what is good and receives honor and favor from the Lord. So today, Casey brings what's good from God to you. And she brings God's favor into your life. It's a beautiful thing. And so treat her right. Treat her well. Look after her. Treat her as yours, your one flesh. And as that grows and develops, if you one has a hurt, it hurts the other too. And so the pain, you don't just say, oh, get over it and get over it. No, her problem's your problem, your problem's their problem. And so we deal with it together. All right. So we are going to have the rings, please, young man. Oh, God has been doing a star job today. Thank you very much. Thank you, Josh. A lot of play, man. So having this kind of love in your hearts for each other, you've chosen to share rings as the sign and seal of the vows that you're making today. Though small in size, these rings are very large in significance. Made of a precious metal, It reminds us that love is not cheap nor common. Indeed, love may cost us dearly. Made in a circle, that tells us that love, our love must never come to an end. And we must keep it continuous. So as you two wear these rings together or apart for a brief moment, may there be constant reminder of these glad promises you're making to each other today. Can you face each other, please? That's the long finger, right? There you go. All right. Brent, will you say these words off for me, Casey? I give you this ring. As a symbol of my promise.
As a symbol of my promise.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The amazing when you stand up here, your brain goes to party. You don't even know what left and right is anymore. Okay, you are. Casey, will you say these words after the ring? I give you this ring. As a symbol of my promise.
As a symbol of my promise.
And with all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And
of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen. Okay, good stuff. Thank you, Bobby. Thank you, guys. So you two have come today before us and before God as witnesses. You have expressed your desire to be husband and wife. You have shown your love and affection for each other by joining hands. You have made sincere promises of love and devotion to each other. You seal these promises with the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore pronounce that you are husband and wife. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift his countenance on you and give you his peace. Amen. What God has joined together, let man not separate. Brent, you may now kiss your bride. You guys were clicking away there. You go, no, you know. Another one. Okay, so I'm going to ask the matron of honor and the best man to... get the, we're going to do a knot tying ceremony. And so I'm going to get them to, Ecclesiastes chapter 4 verse 12 tells us, it says, though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken. This just symbolizes that marriage is a covenant. The only third party in a marriage is the Lord. Well done, Bruce. There you go, look at that. Ask the parents to join us as we sign the register, and the congregation could make their way out. And Mr. Bruce Knight is going to be your MC. He will arrange you in a sort of guard of honor. There'll be some petals at the door on your way out, and just form a guard of honor, and we will be back with you in a little while. Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah.
is aglow. Shoots up through the stony ground. There's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're out of luck.
Ladies and gentlemen, it gives us great pleasure.
And the reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck. Take you out of this place, somewhere you can lay a hand in return for grace. It's a beautiful day.
Ladies and gentlemen, let us welcome for the very first time as husband and wife, Brent and Casey Bauer. Please give your helpful applause. Thanks. Please be seated for the first dance.
Hold your future in my hands. All you ask for, I'll give you more. Honey, I will see this through. Can't stop loving you. I know it's getting late, but every second I'm with you, I'm feeling younger. And when we're done here, I'll grow on you. Come wind, come rain, come thunder. Oh, now I'm not scared of the fall. I'll risk it all. In my hands, all you ask for, I'll give you more. Honey, I will see this through.
nothing but you. Can I have this dance? When I love you, you know you're my desire. Now I'm not scared of the fall, I'll risk it all. Hold your future in my hands. All you ask for, I'll give you all. You're my woman, I'm your man. All you ask for, I'll give you all. Honey, I will see.
Good evening, everybody. For those of you who haven't met me yet, I'm Bruce Knight. I'm Brent's uncle and have asked to be Master of Ceremonies for the evening. Casey, you're looking beautiful today. It's been a really good one. And Brent, you're not looking too shabby yourself. Looking up nice. Good work. I wasn't asked to say a speech or anything, but thought I might just say a few words. So I obviously have known Brent his whole life, being his uncle. I was like the fun guy. They would come and stay with us for the weekend. And ice cream, breakfast, lunch and supper. No veggies, no anything. That was mom's problem to sort out when we got home. Had a couple of balls ups along the way. It took him when he was 13 to do the desert run in Namibia. Didn't realize at 13 we weren't supposed to go one for one with Jägermeister and Stroh Rum. It was a difficult evening, and the next day's riding was more difficult. But yeah, it has carved him into the man that he is now, so it's all been good. I just want to have a look here. That's about it for that. From the time when you met Casey, you became a very different person and a much better person for meeting her. Calmed down a lot. Casey has definitely been, in our opinion, a hugely positive influence on your life. And Casey, it's from our side, our family, it's been a huge honor getting to know you, your help and guidance, especially with the horse side of things, which seems to dominate our lives at the moment, has been invaluable to us. So if we can please all be upstanding for the toast. May your love be modern enough to survive the times and old-fashioned enough to last forever. To Brent and Casey. Cheers, guys.
I don't know if many of you watched what I've just done. I did it very slowly and carefully. I've just used two balls to hold my paper straight. It is a guy thing. It's a wonderful honor and privilege to welcome you guys here again to this very, very special day of Brent and Casey's wedding. I'd like to make a couple of thank yous, but again, I'm not going to do what Bruce Knight, the ex-MC, did, is crush the first part of my speech with his. You didn't hear the scratching of pencils to correct and take out what he'd already said. So I'm very aware that Brent and Wes are going to be talking and Lauren's going to be talking after me, so I'll try and keep it brief. Family and friends for attending. Some of you guys have traveled a massive distance. I know we've got people from Kokstad, from PE, from White River, Nelspruit, and probably people that have come from further afield. Thank you so much for making that special effort to be with us tonight. I'd also like us just to briefly remember those that aren't with us because of distance or prior commitments, but those that have passed and couldn't be with us because of that. Just spare them a thought, please. Then a really special thanks to Pastor Richard Pratt and his wife, Abby. Richard and myself have been at school. We're at school for, it felt like forever, but we did the Standard 6 to matric together. He was a wonderful man then, and he's a wonderful man now. Richard, thank you so much for what you and Abby did for both of my girls, bearing in mind, and we'll touch on it briefly, that Lauren, my younger daughter, was married in May this year, and Casey obviously got married now. Thank you both for what you did for them. It was really tremendous and very of huge value to them. Thank you. I'm certainly like this microphone. People just pay so much more attention to you when you're loud like this. A special thank you must also go and mention to my wife, Marianne. Boss, you've done so well. You and Lauren and all your helpers to put this together, both weddings in the space of 5 months, you guys are absolute machines. Well done, eh? I don't think there's anybody else on the planet that could have done that. My job was easy. I just had to stay on the farm and make sure the wheels kept turning. You guys did all the hard work. Well done. Now, I think it's time to take a little closer look at the bride and groom. They're sitting here sort of in the background, and I think there's things that you guys need to know about them. Important things. The first one that I really find quite interesting is that they met in 2012, these two. And they immediately, they fell head over heels in love and decided to get married. And here we are 10 years later. I've never really got an answer from them, and perhaps that'll come out this evening. I don't know. Maybe it's not important. But just a word to them, and that you can use this, don't use it, exactly as you feel. If you're going to have a family, I'd start focusing on that kind of thing fairly soon. By middle age, you're going to find it much more difficult. And the way you guys go on, it's going to take a while. So get on. What I have, on a very personal level, what I have been doing a lot over the last couple of weeks and months, because I've been on the farm on my own, nobody to talk to, they've all been going to makeup practice. Why do you practice with your makeup? Your face doesn't move around, it stays right there. Makeup practice, hair things, food tastings, the works. I've had time to really cast my mind back over Casey's life and the very special memories that Casey has provided for me and for our family. And there's one particular vision and view of Casey that is absolutely burnt into my mind. And if I can, with your permission, I'm just going to step back and try and portray that for you. Just liven it up and paint a picture of what I'm seeing right now. Is first of all, you've got to imagine Casey when she was little. She had hair that was absolutely uncontrollable, a shock of white hair, and it would stick up at the back like this. No matter what Miran tried to do, that was Casey. So you could see her in a crowd of her peers because part of her stuck up like this. Such a pretty girl, magnificent smile. She didn't stop smiling until I think she met Brent, but I don't know. Lovely girl. What Casey did or used to do at the time in her life, remember she's gone from the bunny onesie that kids are in. When they start crawling, they get more robust clothes put on them. And around that time in her life when she was starting to stand up and toddle around a little bit, we had some fantastic female staff on the farm. The ladies were so good, and they'd have Casey with them at lunchtime to give Marianne and myself a break. And they'd sit out on the lawn and eat together, and Casey would walk through their plates of food, you know, and do things that I think kids would like to do. But what the important thing to note now, to get this picture right in your minds, you've got the shock of white hair, you've got Casey in her second grade onesie, but Casey was one of those rare kids that went from crawling to walking with no pause in between. She then went from walking to sprinting within days. And she was so quick, she'd go from sitting on her bum to standing up to full tilt, down the passage, past the TV, out the front door, across the lawn, down the terrace, and straight into the bush, straight into the garden. And she'd disappear, but she couldn't back out, see, because she hadn't learned to reverse. So she'd be there for hours while the staff hunted her down. She'd also then adapt that behavior to lunchtime. So while the staff were trying to enjoy their lunch in that precious hour that they had, Casey would be whistling past them and then into the bush, just with her bum showing, if we were lucky. And you could see this wore off, the novelty wore off after a couple of weeks. And I Miranda and myself, one particular lunchtime, said to each other, you know, it's bloody quiet out there. I wonder if Casey's gone so far into the bush they can't find her. Let's go and check up and see. And what we saw, lo and behold, was the most rustic scene you could imagine. The staff were sitting down happily. There was one of those cardboard apple cartons, if you remember them, and that was sticking out the top. the staff had put Casey in, then they'd chosen the box with a proportion so cleverly that she couldn't get up. She couldn't stand up because she'd fall over onto her face. She couldn't get out, but she could peer through those upright slots like that. She could sort of engage with what was going on. Wonderful. So there, if you can see that picture that I'm seeing, that is one of the most wonderful memories I've got of Casey and how the world tamed her. Brent, on the other hand, very, very reluctant have Brent's family been to share that kind of story or any similar story to me, but I know with me, I know one thing for sure is Brent is a dyed-in-the-wool farm boy. He's never going to be anything else. He's happiest when he's looking, touching, starting, revving machinery. And as a result of that, he's building a very, very nice little contracting business for himself that I'm very proud to see. It's a wonderful picture to see this happening. But something that you may not know about Brent is he was quite a good rugby player in his day, but he broke his neck one day on the field. Grievous injury, had very, very potentially bad consequences for him, but he healed from it. He had some good treatment, I think, timeously. Neck injury, but you see, it hasn't stopped him from necking with my daughter for the past 10 years. So we'll leave that there, but to say that we now have thing two, and we're going to deal with this now, thing two joining my family. Thing one joined our family in May. Okay. And I'm doing this not to take anything away from your wedding, but it's got to be said. Dr. Seuss, I was raised on Dr. Seuss, Cat in the Hat books. Green Eggs and Ham, huh? Yep. The Grinch that stole Christmas. That was my upbringing. And it's profound stuff that I'm so glad that my parents provided me with that reading matter. If any of you guys have seen the Cat in the Hat movie, you would have seen thing one and thing two. Two little red-clad dervishes with big number one and big number two bouncing off the walls, destroying things. And going back about 8-10 years now, when you guys met each other, I can't help but had that burnt into my brain that, gee, Peters, this is now thing one and thing two, and I'm going to have to live with them. And everything and anything that is portrayed in those books or in the movie, I see and deal with every day. And I'm very, very happy. So welcome belatedly, thing one and thing two, to the family. Welcome. We're nearly at a close now. And I would like to just address some very personal comments from Marianne and myself, and from Jeff and Debbie, and also from the grandparents who've played a role in raising these two. Is that it's so easy to see what a wonderful friendship you guys have. It's just so plain to see. You're great mates and you care so deeply for each other, and it's a wonderful thing as a parent to see that in your relationship. Gorgeous to see. Your home is full of happiness and dogs. So along with the happiness comes a lot of dog spittle, but it is just such a happy, welcoming place. Thank you for the home that you put together that we all feel so welcome in. Marianne, Debbie, Jeff, grandparents, we've done a pretty good job raising these two, I think. So well done to all of you. You can give yourself a great big pat on the back. And really, you two, your two families are so proud of you. Well done for the young people that you've become. Now, I'm going to ask you to raise and drink a toast with me from the families to Brent and Casey, if we could do that, if we could rise and drink a toast to them. A last point, if I may, before you sit down. This was actually the speech that I wrote for Lauren and Wesley's wedding. I had the wrong paper in my pocket. That's not bad for winging it, is it? Yeah?
Is it on now?
Yes.
I got to follow that now. Okay. Don't even start. Good evening, everybody. I'd like to send out a warm thank you for joining us on this very special day. And I'd like to raise my own toast, and probably for everybody here, when I say it's about bloody time. Okay?
What's that?
The day has finally arrived, and we get to celebrate these two wonderful people and the love that they share. I would like to start off with Mr. Bauer. I first met Brent in 2012, when the two of them began dating. And at this early stage, I could see that he had no idea what he was getting himself into. Poor guy. But to his credit, he stuck it out, and he even got past the dreaded meeting her father stage. So at this point, I knew he was serious. We've all spent many a fun time together, from fearing for your life on your behalf while he rode his motorbike, to family dinners, social get-togethers, etc. But it's been the time spent over the years watching his love and devotion for my sister blossom and grow that has been an absolute privilege to watch. So Brent, thank you for loving Casey the way you do. Thank you for supporting her through some challenging times and being an unwavering pillar of strength in her life. I also thank you for being such a kind, strong, and positive force in my life. I couldn't have asked for a better brother-in-law.
Well,
I'm trying, yeah. And then my dear sister, where do I begin? I think it's fair to say we've both kept mom and dad on their toes growing up. And we've done our duty as kids and well and truly given them grey hairs. Sorry, Oaks, but you can go on holiday now, it's fine. But on a serious note, it makes me so proud to be standing here this evening and having the honour of standing by your side as your maid of honour, a position I do not take lightly. We've been through many ups and downs, you and I, but I couldn't have wished for a more perfect person to be my big sister. You have shown immense strength when life has been tough. You have shared joy with all of us. You are unwavering in the knowledge of who you are as a person, something that I truly admire. But you have also shown me what joy can still be found when you follow your passions. Thank you, Moira and Derek. My sister is now a crazy dog lady. My wish for you was that you one day found your person, and you certainly have in Brent. The two of you were made for each other, and I cannot wait to watch the rest of your love story unfold. I love you both. Thank you for letting me be part of your journey, and here's to many more happy years to come.
Good evening, everyone. Firstly, I'd just like to thank everybody for joining us. This has been the most amazing day, and I'm sure you guys have enjoyed it. And you guys are looking absolutely amazing. I mean, you clean up well. Your missus cleans up a lot better. I mean, after we saw you this morning, I'm sorry, that was bad. That was bad. So now, a little bit of seriousness. Mr. Bauer, we've known each other for a little bit longer than 7 years. But it's these past 7 years that have meant the most. I mean, you used to take him cooler, and you used to balega there and go make squabby bales, and then we get into shit for it. We used to get into trouble for it, and yeah, it was good, you know. The only thing I will complain about, though, is you making me go into the forager. Yeah. The dominator, the rust bucket, the thing on wheels that was... And because I was the skinniest and the smallest, I had to climb in and I had to sort out what he had jammed up. Then you go back to the workshop and you come back and I'd have to do it all over again. And he sits there and he's like, can I pass you any spanners? Meanwhile, him and Andrew just bugger off over down there and I'm the one to sort it out. But out of everything, the 7 years and some, there's one day that stood out the most. And that was the day of your bull's party. So let me just paint a little picture for you. We were very, very kind enough. Jeff organized us to go to a game reserve close by. And, you know, it was beautiful, absolutely beautiful. And they had buffalo and a lot of antelope. Waterbuck for the first time I've seen them. It's fantastic. It was very, like, I was so excited because we sat, myself, Jace, and the guys, we sat in the back and we're like, we bought Punishment of Tafel Lager. Now, I don't know if there's anybody here that drinks Tafel Lager, but I'll be honest, it's the worst beer I've ever tasted in my entire life. So we decided we'd leave a six-pack in the sun, and if we saw the buffalo, yeah, you'd have to down it. Well, after the first game drive with Mike and Jeff, we saw bugger all. So we're like, okay, fine, Jace, you and Brent, just drink, it's fine. So they drank two. Then, with a lot of refreshments and a bra, and it was fantastic. We decided, hey, you know what, guys? Let's go for like an afternoon, early evening game drive. So we're going at Jace. I mean, chap, you got us lost. I don't know how many times, but we did. And eventually, we were driving. We decided, listen, guys, let's just go up towards the Buffalo Camp one last time. We've got to make a plan. Almost a Perry, he's standing on the back there, and he says, oh, Brent, you're in shit now. And there it was, in their magnificence, the entire herd of the male and female buffalo. We got there, and Brent was like, he was speechless. He didn't know what to say or what to do. We're chatting and everything, having a couple of drinks, and you hear this like a flat tire noise. Okay. Jace climbs out of his van. There's Brent. He doesn't want to go back to the lodge to drink the tafel. He's letting down the tires. So we're like, no, you can't. I'm not walking a couple of Ks. I'm sorry. It's not going to happen. Where's Brent? Guys, where's Brent? There's a big stack of bales. He's gone. Mr. Power had my leg, and he's like, oh, we're not going back. But it was good. So he went back to the thing, and you drank the tafels, and it was fantastic. And Brent, I just hope that every day in marriage, you take like you drank those tafels. Slowly, with a smile. And I will be honest, earlier on I came in here and I'm pretty sure I saw, there's a buffalo. There we go, done. Where's that? There we go, we got it. There we go. Unfortunately, we couldn't find tafel, so we got the next best thing. But please, can everybody stand and raise a toast to the bride and groom? You guys have had the most amazing day. Cheers.
Good evening, everybody. I hope you're all having a good evening on the special day, sharing in with us. And everyone seems to be having a good laugh so far. I've taken a little bit of time here because everything I wanted to say has pretty much been said, but it's time to put it in my way of doing things. So let's hope to keep this interesting. And here we go. So I'd just like to start off by saying to my beautiful wife, you look absolutely amazingly gorgeous. So to fill everyone in on this little joke that we have, we got engaged about a year ago and Casey hijacked my phone. And yes, the one day I'm looking for a number and I'm so used to going to the name, flipping through. Eventually, I've got it memorized. I put in the number, and I see she's changed her name. So I look at it, phone her. I say to her, hello. She says, what do you see on the screen? So I said, fiance. She's like, that's not how you pronounce it. So I said to her, well, that's the whole point. It's got the cuppy key on the end, so it's got the flair fianché. So she then turned around and tried to stump me again and said, okay, well, when we married then, what are you going to call me? So took a couple of seconds. I couldn't go with straight wife, so I thought, what about Y-Fi? Well, it didn't go down too well, but for her to hear that this evening really means a lot to her, and I see she's glowing because of it. So, Casey, I love you to bits. I hope you guys all enjoyed that one. Now to figure out the rest of the stuff I had to say. Shucks. Now, I'd just like to say, on behalf of both of us, again, thank you to all for joining us on our special day. It really means a lot for everyone to be here. For those who couldn't be with us and for those who passed on, glad to know that their presence is in the background. And due to the video and the photographers, they'll be able to catch up on this a bit later on. I'd just like to do a couple of special thank yous to a couple of people that have really put in a little bit of extra effort and really helped pull this all together. So I'd like to start off with just saying thanks to Sandra for doing all the flowers and a bit of the decor around. It looks absolutely amazing. I'd like to say thank you to Angelique for all the food that we've just eaten and and just keeping us topped up throughout the day, the energy levels up for when we hit the dance floor later. So thank you. The next thank you goes out to the Knight family for coming all the way from Mpumalanga. And so I'd just like to say thanks for the journey all the way down here just to be with us on this special day. To Casey's second family from PE, as they are known, thank you guys for also traveling up from so far. We really appreciate you being here and sharing in with us. Okay, there's quite a few of these, so we can be clapping a bit. To the band, unfortunately, the guys had to duck it. One of them wasn't feeling too great, but we've still got Richard around. So to you guys, thank you very much for keeping everyone occupied while we were off doing our photos. Good job. To DJ, who will be keeping us entertained later, thank you for coming through and keeping us entertained till late tonight. To the Hilton Bush Lodge, thank you guys for an awesome venue and a special place for us to come in and just share in our special day and uniting one another. If there is anyone that I have forgotten about, I very sheepishly say that, because if I have, it's not by ill intention, but thank you to everyone who's put in an effort, even being the small, silly little things. Thank you so much in bringing this all together and just being here with us and having a great time today. So thank you very much. Right, I'm getting through. Yeah, 104. Yeah, yeah, 104. I'd like to move on to a very interesting subject now that we're done with the thank yous. I'd like to move on to chatting a little bit about Mark and Marianne. This was quite a tough one for me. It could have gone one of several ways, but here goes nothing. I'd like to take things back to the first dinner we ever had, and I got to meet you guys and kind of got welcomed to the family. I'll absolutely never forget it. Warming up to this occasion, Casey's planning, and yes, yeah, no, we need to get this sorted, and off we go, and she's giving me a little bit of insight here and there. Do this, don't do that, get that ready, dress like this, do that. So I had a pretty good warm-up. The last kind of tips she gave me just before I arrived was, watch out for my dad, Mike. He can be quite intense in his questioning when he's getting to know someone. So I kind of sat back. I was like, okay, no problems. I'm pretty sure we can do this. We'll keep going. She said, you're about my mom. It depends on what mood you catch her in. But no, going back to that, from all the experience up until now, I just realized that Mike was that intense because he really loves his daughters and he just wants the very best for them. So thank you, Mike, for that. Marianne, on the other hand, gave me a little bit of a hard time. I was quite surprised by this, considering the advice I'd got from Casey. But exactly the same. Marianne also just likes to have her bit and make sure that she's heard. And she also just has the best intentions at heart. So for that, Marianne, thank you very much. Anyways, moving back to this dinner. So we were cruising through, everything was going well, the questioning, all that side of things was going pretty smoothly because we're sitting here today. The next thing, the awkward thing in the room pops up. Roast chicken comes out. Mr. Bauer, would you like to carve? So I was a little taken aback. But no problems, take it in the stride, get there, think, crikey, Dad, did you give me enough lessons in this? I don't remember anything. What do we do first? Do we cut it in half? Do we take the wings off? Do we take the thighs? Oh, well, let's just give it a bash, and off we went. But again, everything obviously went off without a hitch, and we've made it to where we are today. So firstly, I'd just like to say a big thank you to you guys for all the support and love that you've given us over these years. Little bit of guidance here and there, maybe a nip in the ear now and again, a bit of a kick in the backside, but thank you for always being there just as a backstop and just as a bit of a buffer, and just we know that we've got someone in our corner in the background, so thank you very much for that. Again, on another thank you for you guys. We're not quite done yet. I'd just like to say a very big thank you on raising this beautiful and amazing woman that's sitting by my side here this evening. If it wasn't for you guys, I don't think she would be as she is today. She's the light of my life, my best friend, the most precious thing to me. So for that, I think it deserves a big round of applause and a big thank you to you guys for raising this beautiful woman right here. Right. Now comes a tricky one. I've also got to find my place here. Not yet. Mom and Dad, this one had me puzzling for a long time. You can ask several people around the room. I sat and I puzzled and I went this way and I went that way and I went this way again and I went back that way and I proofread through a couple of people just in joking conversations. They didn't really even know that I was running part of my speech. But finally I came down and your guys is unfortunately short and sweet, but it's straight to the point, and I hope it sits with you guys. Through the years, you guys have come together, and you've helped shape me into the man I am today. Thank you both for being there when I needed the extra nudge, or the little nip around the ear. You guys seem to have got it right, because look how it turned out. The biggest thank you that I have for you, Mom and Dad, is again, always being there silently in the background, supporting myself and my beautiful bride as we travel this journey. Just adding words of advice every now and again along the way and just nudging us along in the right direction. So for this, thank you both. Can we please just raise a glass? To Jeff and Debbie. Righty-ho. This page was a little bit wasted. Soon as I pretty much covered most of what I needed to cover. But we're going to give this a bash anyways. Wesley, Blabbers, Blom, Wiggs. These several nicknames, they kind of stuck around over the years. I'm not sure where half of them come from. But I think a couple of them are self-explanatory. We've known each other for quite a while. I think our friendship stems back from right when we were youngsters. We kind of met without really even knowing at that age and kind of carried on through life. And a couple of years ago, I couldn't remember the number correctly. Wes seems to have it nailed at 7 years, 7, 8 years ago. We kind of came back together in the whole contracting game, and that's kind of like our speciality. It's what we both enjoy. So it drew us both together again, and we kind of got in touch with one another. And, I just wanted to say to Wes again, keeping it short and sweet, I was going to go with a couple of stories, but I think that's for another night. For a lot of people's sakes. I've still got a reputation I need to uphold, yeah. No, Wes, I just wanted to say to you, thank you for your wise words of wisdom. Thank you for just being with me. And our thing is kind of just being silly buggers. So as soon as we're stressed, we're silly buggers. As soon as we're uneasy, we're silly buggers. When we're working, we're silly buggers. Unfortunately, we're friends with some other silly buggers, but it's all just silly buggers. There we go. That's where it comes from. So, thing one, me, thing two, we're sorted, eh? Good girl, my boy. Thanks for just randomly popping up every now and again, out of the blue, checking in, whether it's to play Farming Simulator or whatever it is, just thank you guys for also just being there and, just being around and just being friends and just cruising through life, causing mischief like we always do, trying to stay out of trouble, never works, still battling with that one today, but just a big thank you to you for just having my back. And I know the last little while has been a bit rough, been a bit bossy, but I learned that from someone. But she's an absolute superstar, so. But yeah, no, Wes, thank you very much. Yeah, tackle those buffaloes. Where's the hunters in the room? I think on this one I've saved Lauren close to the end. We've got the Double Trouble Sisters close on my end radar here, so let's give this a bash. Righty-ho. Toot, you mentioned back in the beginning. In a Peninging, yes, there, when we're still lots of wheelie, yeah, wop wop, lots of photos, that's the one. I met Lauren right when Casey and I first started dating and getting to know one another. And her first couple impressions, I wasn't quite sure how to take them. She's got that redhead fieriness that you just never quite know. So the first couple of times she was okay, polite, I suppose. Just sussing things out. Checking you up and down every now and again, like, hey, my man, what's your intentions? You know I've got my daddy on speed dial. Watch out, watch out. Shucks. But fortunately, I think from the beginning, we seemed to click and form a special bond along while I was getting to know your sister, helping me along the way, a little bit of advice here and there. Do this, do that. Are you sure you did? Hey, when? Yeah, just relax, Max. It's sorted. Don't worry. She was always there in the background, just nudging and stirring the pot, as she can do. But Toot, thank you so much. You've taught me what a sister is all about. I have one of my own, but this is a different type of sister. So thank you for that, and keep pushing me. Yes, nearly there. There are a couple of thank yous that I've purposely left close to the end, just in case they thought I'd forgotten about them. And there's a couple of shy ones around, a couple hiding here and there. To the bridesmaids, you girls look amazing this evening. Good job in getting everything sorted, and thank you so much for looking after my beautiful bride. To the groomsmen. Yeah, you finyasses. Yeah. Touch and go. It was touch and go. Touch and go. But you guys, thanks for having my back, and thanks for giving me the extra nudge over the finish line. Thank you very much. There's one that I'm going to improvise on a little bit here. Is my sister. She thought I'd forgotten about her sitting here in the corner. One of the few I'd left for last. Should I go left or should I go right? Straight down the middle. Here we go. Right, so this is Leanne, my little sister, for those of you that don't know. No, I'm kidding. Lee, again, short and sweet. Thank you for always sitting around, taking my nonsense. I know it can be a pain to you sometimes, but someone's got to make sure you can deal with him. So just keeping you on your toes there. But thank you as well for just always being there. And sometimes bring me back down to earth when I go a little bit high with the helium balloons. But thank you for just being you and who you are and helping at the best of times, keeping me grounded. So thank you for that. Right, I don't want to bore any of you any further. So I'm going to conclude with just a short line to my beautiful bride. This was improvised from this morning, so bear with me if it's a little bit rusty here and there. So we'll go with a short little storyline and then I'll end off. This morning, we're getting ready. I've got ants in my pants, so I was awake from 4 o'clock, up and down, up and down, up and down. Eventually, Mom's right next door. Mom, please come for coffee. I don't know what to do with myself. I've got everything ready. I'm all sorted. There's no one else coming up yet. The guys haven't come. Come keep me busy. Ah, no problem. comes around, keeps me busy, buys some time, leaves to go and do makeup, comes back, fills us in. Case is doing well, everything's going according to plan, 100%. The next minute, Wesley arrives, and that's only trouble. But he was bringing me, I think, the most special gift I've received in the years that we've been together. Just a little note that made me realize that Casey knows me better than anyone in this room. And she knows exactly how to tug on my heartstrings. I read that. I said to the guys, give me 5 minutes. I'm just going to quickly check this out. I'll be back with you now. It was about half an hour, 45 minutes later. I came out the room and everyone looked at me and said, "Are you all right, my bro?" But no, babe, thank you so much. That really just calmed me down this morning after cutting me up. But it calmed me down and it pulled on the heartstrings and it got the right ones. And it got us to where we are now. So for that, I thank you. And I'd just like to end off by saying, you're my best friend. I'm stuck with you for life now. So let's just keep this moving forward. I love you to bits. And you're the most precious thing in this world. On that note, I'd just like to raise a glass and toast to my beautiful bride, Casey. Power, by the way. Before we close off, I'd just like to call in a couple of my groomsmen and a couple of individuals. Eric, Vian, Marco, Jason, you're definitely up, my friend. And I think that should cut it. We have a little surprise planned for you guys, so if everyone wouldn't mind remaining seated, and I will chat to Bruce and we'll get the next 5 minutes sorted.
Shake that. ride. Booty moving weight like she on the block. With a drink, I got to know. Tight jeans, tattoo, cause I'm rock and roll. Half black, half white, diamond, no. Gang of money.
Yeah, I'm running through these halls like Drano. I got that devilish flow, rock and roll, no halo. We party rock. Yeah, that's the crew that I'm repping. On a rise to the top, no Lennon or Zeppelin.
Hey, party rock is in the house tonight. Woo! Everybody just have a good time.
Yeah,
and we gon' make you lose your mind. Everybody just have a good time.
Every day I'm shuffling.
First girl to make me throw this cash. We get money, don't be mad. Now stop, hating is bad.
One more shot for us,
another round.
Please fill up my cup,
don't mess around.
We just want to see
you shaking
now. Now you home with me.
You're naked now.
Get up, get down, put your hands up.